Jarren. Welcome back to another video. I want to bring you something very cool. This is a Popular Mechanics magazine from 1948. And I'm very excited to kind of walk through some of this with you because this is the exact type of content that I find so interesting and intriguing. This is just a brief snapshot of things that were happening in February of 1948. But more so than that, I think one of the cool things about looking into a magazine from the past is that you get to see what people thought the future would look like, not necessarily what the future actually was. Before we dig in, I want to let you know that I'm going to be giving away this version of the Popular Mechanics magazine on my Patreon page. So if you would like to support me there, I'm going to start regularly doing giveaways. I have this one, I have a Popular Science magazine here, which is pretty exciting. I'm gonna dig into that one in another video, but this one specifically will be given away this coming week. So if you would like to support me on Patreon, help me make these videos, help me make my design work, then I will send a link your way, and I'm excited to give this away to someone. So digging into this magazine, one of the first things I noticed was the advertising, because the advertising is very noticeably 40s and 50s, especially because this is the late 40s. We're looking at a lot of hand-drawn work. Remember, at the time, we didn't have digital tools to design these things, so everything is handwritten and then printed. Very few colors. Most of these things are in black and white. And for the most part, every now and then, there's a page with an accent color, so they'll just add a pop of green or a pop of orange to maybe brighten everything up. So one of my absolute favorite things is the way they spoke during that time and just different terminology. I love that it says, "Get into diesel now," as if diesel is something I can just get into. They mentioned the title of the industry and they just invite you to get into it. Go get some work done in diesel. So even though this magazine is 70 years old, there are still a lot of things that you kind of recognize. There's some Volkswagen vehicles. Cars are becoming more prominent in society. There are people making kit cars. One of the biggest changes I've noticed is that smoking is no longer encouraged. That's a big difference in culture nowadays. There is a whole section on basket weaving. So if you've ever been very interested in basket weaving, you can learn directly from the masters in the 1940s. And there's a very common thread of be your own boss. You too can make big money in the building industry. No, sorry. You too can make big money in building industry. They don't say the, they don't state the diesel industry, the building industry. It's just industry. One of my favorite small little adverts was for this Corgi amazing portable motorcycle, which is very interesting because at the time, I don't know if I had seen anything about that size. I know perhaps in the 80s, there was a Japanese car that had a motorcycle inside of the trunk. So you could drive from the countryside, park your car outside the city limits, and then ride your little motorcycle around. But I don't know if I had ever seen anything like that from the 1940s. So for $17.50, I think that is $17.50. Yep, $17.50. You can get the 400, a precision automatic adding machine. So if you've ever need to do simple math, this is the tool for you. It's only $17.50 and you can do addition. There's a lot of military surplus in here as well, and it's really crazy to see as the Industrial Revolution is growing. They're calling it the Industrial Revolution here, and they focus on so many interesting little aspects of it. A walkie-talkie that weighs 11 ounces. Look at this guy with his walkie-talkie and little radio. That is so funny. One of the things that I think is so crazy is that this book came out before the moon landing. It came out before super glue, before the hula hoop. This is a whole different world, and their outlook on the future is definitely something to behold. Anyway, if you're interested, I can do a full walkthrough of this at some point in time, and if you would like to get it, support me on Patreon. I'm excited to send more your way. I promise it won't always be retro tech related. Sometimes it will be future tech. I'm about to do a review of something called Blue Land. It's a cleaning supply, future-focused cleaning supplies, essentially. It's actually pretty well designed. I'm actually so eager to review that. I'm going to keep one for myself, and I'm going to purchase and mail one to someone out there who's supporting me on Patreon. I'm also going to be working on some new products. I'm going to be releasing a bunch of stuff over the next couple of months. The first one, I'm actually going to make a poster about a video that I've made previously, my concepts video where I talked about the universal library. I plan on making an entire poster on that, and I should have that your way soon. I think that's going to be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you're excited to see more of the popular mechanics and popular science content. This retro tech is always fun to dig into. I'll have links to everything below, and I'm excited to talk to you again very soon. Thanks a lot for watching. You can always see what I'm doing on TikTok or Twitter. Yeah, that's right. I post TikTok videos. You can follow me on those platforms, and I will talk to you again very soon.